miraculous power into our lives. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Man, when the kids are not listening, have a little patience with God and be faithful. When the house is a mess, trust God and be faithful. When your spouse does not seem to care about your needs, trust God and do the next thing. Be faithful. When you have more bills to pay than you have money, trust in Him and be faithful. When someone calls you a nasty name, trust in God and be faithful. When someone talks behind you, around your back, oh, be faithful. When dysfunctional situations seem to be eating your lunch, trust in Him and be faithful. When it seems like no one cares, be faithful. When you're scared to death and life is eating your lunch, trust in God and be faithful. When you've done your best and your best doesn't seem good enough, trust in God and the Jesus who's interceding on your behalf, and walk on the water, get out of the boat, and be faithful. Amen?
Amen.
This morning I was jotting down notes and I thought, the truth is, Elsie, we know that Jesus intercedes, but sometimes we don't get prayers answered like we want them answered. Isn't that true? Somewhere along the journey, we grow up and we realize, well, God answered my prayer, but it wasn't like I wanted. Do we trust God or not? Do we trust God or not? He answers our prayers the way He sees fit. Amen?
Yeah.
It doesn't mean that Jesus did not intercede. It meant that Jesus interceded and God answered the prayer and did what He thought was best. And then I know that there are some of us, Nathalie, who've been praying about something for a long, long time. We've got to discern the difference between no and not yet. You see, we don't get that, Miss Velma? In our prayer life, there's a difference between no and not yet. And my guess is there are people all over the sanctuary, Dr. Spann, who are praying like there's no tomorrow, asking Jesus to intercede. God's getting ready, but God keeps saying, hey, I'm saying not yet, not no. I want to see how much faith you've got. I'm going to see if you're willing to trust me through the difficult times. I want to see if you really believe what you say you believe, or if things don't go your way, do you tuck tail and run?
Amen.
God's on the throne today, amen?
Amen.
All by Himself. And we serve a high priest who is familiar with the feelings of our infirmities.
Amen.
Thank heavens. How does that? What a friend we have in Jesus. All our sins and griefs to bear. What a privilege to carry everything to God. Red Lobster and wherever we're at, and the people that we rub shoulders with know that these people really believe what they say they believe. There's no situation in their lives that's bigger than the great God that they serve. Amen?
Amen.
God's got it. Say it with me. God's got it. Would you stand with me? Let's pray together. Father, thank you for your message. The truth is, it all stemmed from the idea that you moved with compassion and pity, reached out your hand and said, "Hey, Mr. Leper, I'm willing to touch you." And then you took us through a window, celebrating the idea that we have a high priest who is familiar with the feelings of our infirmities. Thank you for your compassion, Lord. You are good. Your love is good. And we are more than victors through you who love us. So